A new episode of The Mandalorian means a new breakdown of all the Easter eggs. Here are the Star Wars references you might have missed from Season 2, Episode 2. Chapter 10, the passenger takes Mando and the child on a series of side quests as they continue trying to take the child home. The duo make a new friend and run into some trouble along the way. There are also quite a few Easter eggs and Star Wars references hidden in plain sight. The first alien species we see setting up a trap for Mando is a Nikto, known for their scaly skin and symmetrical horns and spikes on their faces. Back in Episode 1, Mando and IG-11 faced off with Nikto guards at the facility where they found the child. The other alien that takes a jetpack could be a Tito, as seen in The Force Awakens. Before leaving Mos Eisley, Mando stops by the cantina that first appeared in A New Hope. The recreation of this location is pretty spot on, with plenty of scum and villainy milling around. While it's hard to say for sure, Dr. Mandible, the massive ant-like creature, looks a lot like the species called Killick. If that is what the Good Doctor is, it marks the first live-action appearance of the species. The creatures were first introduced in the novel Dark Nest 1, The Joiner King. It's also pretty funny that Ant-Man director Peyton Reed directed this particular episode, given that led him directing another very large ant. Peli and Dr. Mandible are playing a game of Sabacc. This widely popular game was first mentioned in Empire Strikes Back, but it also appeared in Rebels and The Force Awakens, and was heavily featured in Solo.
So this is, Sabacc?
Sabacc.
If you haven't been to Star Wars Galaxy's Edge at Disneyland or Walt Disney World, you probably missed this one. Mando passes a Wed-15 Treadwell droid roasting meat on a podracer engine. When visiting Galaxy's Edge, you can visit an eatery called Ronto Roaster that purports to cook its meat the same way. In reality, the massive burning podracer in the eatery is for show, but it's still nice to see Galaxy's Edge represented.
I'm not some Rodian, for crying out loud.
Peli remarks that she's not some Rodian, referring to the green-skinned species with large pupilless eyes who have popped up throughout the franchise. A number of Rodians worked as bounty hunters like Greedo in A New Hope. Peli tells Mando that the passenger can't travel using hyperdrive, and instead must travel sublight. This refers to sublight engines that let ships fly at speeds below the speed of light. Clearly, Mando doesn't speak whatever language the Frog Lady does. However, he does suggest that they both use Huttese, the language spoken by the Hutts, including Jabba. Sadly, it doesn't seem like she knows that one. The New Republic cops that pull Mando over are flying the iconic X-Wing ship. It gets its name from the shape of its wings when it enters combat mode, as seen in this episode. If you're wondering where you've seen those pilots before, we can help solve that. One of them is Trapper Wolf, played by The Clone Wars and Star Wars Rebels executive producer Dave Filoni. Filoni also directed episodes of The Mandalorian in Season 1 and first appeared as Wolf in Episode 6, The Prisoner. The other pilot was played by actor Paul Sun-Hyung Lee, who you might recognize from the show Kim's Convenience. The pilots mention to Mando that they represent the New Republic. Fans of the politics of Star Wars will remember the New Republic as the government that rose following the destruction of the Empire. You may also remember that the New Republic was wiped out by the First Order in The Force Awakens, because time is a flat circle in Star Wars. Mando may not be a Jedi, and the pilots likely aren't either for that matter. Still, that didn't stop him from throwing out a Jedi pleasantry in hopes it would keep the representatives of the New Republic from wanting to hold him up any longer.
May the Force be with you.
It didn't work. The pilots flag Mando for his involvement in the prison escape in the Season 1 episode Chapter 6, The Prisoner. One of the pilots even mentions Lieutenant Davin, the character played by Matt Lanter. If you're wondering where you've seen the scraps of droid Mando has on his ship, they were introduced last season in Chapter 6. That droid's name was Zero, and it was voiced by Richard Ayoade, who returns in this episode to lend his voice to the character once again. Speaking through Zero, the Frog Lady reminds Mando of the Mandalorian Code. We're not entirely sure how this fits this particular situation, as previously the Mandalorian Code was concerning one-on-one combat to settle disputes. It's how Sabine challenged Fenn Rao on an episode of Star Wars Rebels. The spiders that attack Mando and company are Krikna. These carnivorous creatures were also referred to as crawlers in Star Wars Rebels. The Rebels were attacked by them after building a base on Adalon in the Season 2 episode The Mystery of Chopper Base. Prisoner X6911 is yet another callback to Season 1, Episode 6, The Prisoner. In it, Mando helps free a prisoner, which it turns out the New Republic isn't very happy about.
Sorry, lady, I don't understand frog.
The voice of the Frog Lady should be familiar to some Star Wars fans. She's voiced by Dee Bradley Baker, who was the voice of the Clone Troopers and Commander Rex in Star Wars The Clone Wars. He'll next be heard as the Clone Troopers once more in the animated Star Wars The Bad Batch. What did you think of Chapter 10? Let us know in the comments below and subscribe for more Mandalorian videos.